Hey YouTube. So it's Wednesday, 15th or 16th, somewhere in there, of September. 2 years ago or longer, the first year I bought the sawmill, I made an adapter or jig, whatever you want to call it, that holds a log so that you can cut the log in a true in a true quarter sawn cut with position that I can cut the board, so they're quarter sawn. Now if you look at these, you'll see, you can see how the grain is running on there, and the grain is running straight across the board. I didn't want an almost quarter sawn, I wanted a true quarter sawn, because I wanted to make spindles for the front porch and stuff, you know, the handrail, which I did out of this stuff, and it's worked really well. I want to tell you that, I mean, this board right here, you can see it's touching all of the bunk rails going up there, that end one, it looks just a hair high. But the point is that they're nice and straight, they've held their shape even though they've been drying for 2 years, and now it's time to get them cut. So the problem with my jig that I made is that it's cutting to the center. Based on the log, it's cutting through the center all the time as you turn the log over and everything in the jig. But anyway, those of you who have watched my channel know about the jig I made. I might have forgot about it a little bit, but you know, it is what it is. And this stuff is going to be nice. So I need to square this up now into 2x2s. The problem with the jig also is that I can't find big enough logs to really make it worth your effort to cut quarter sawn cuts, unless you know you're needing small boards, and nothing gets smaller than a 2x2 pretty much. Somebody had made a comment that whenever you cut a 2x2, it's automatically quarter sawn. That is not true. Okay, that's, I don't know where they got the idea, but it's not a true statement. Some are, because you know, it depends on how you cut, but some are not, and I want them all quarter sawn so they stay as straight as they can. So basically right now we've got this is a 3 pieces of quarter sawn stuff, and I'm going to cut these into 2-inch pieces so I can plane spindles out of them. So you'll see as I go here what I'm doing. I'll get back to that quarter sawn stuff in a minute here. I need to go get the camera holder, and I just want to show you the garage here. Now you can see there's a pretty good pile of wood there yet, but that pile was about yay high. So I'm getting there, and it's ending up being some really nice boards. I've got some 1x10 here that's really nice and flat, nice and straight. You can see how flat this one here is. It's a 1x12, a couple of them. And the rest of this stuff is looking pretty good. I've got some spindles here that are oak. I need around 20 more oak spindles, okay? So I need to get 20 of them cut out of that quarter sawn stuff. That's what I'm after. So I can finally get the garage cleaned up, because it's a disaster in here with the dog playing games with the sawdust I have here. But I'm not worried about that right now. I am worried about getting the spindles together so I can have the carpenter come back and finish up the stairs for me. So it's a little cool out this morning. I have a sweatshirt on. It's supposed to be down in the 50s at night, which it has been. And uh,
it's been no higher. It didn't hit 70 yesterday. So anyway, I need to cut a flat spot on these boards so that I can, you know, get a couple 2x2s out of them. I'm not going to be getting many 2x2s out of that, and it's actually a waste of, you know, the flat board to try to get the quarter sawn boards out of it, but they're worth having. So that's what I'm working on. Looks like I can square up the top of those two. This one's too low for me to square it up. I'll square it up on the next cut. But all I want to do is put a flat top on that so that I can get 2x2s out of it, whatever I can get. Probably get the 2, which will make 4. So 4, 8 of them. It's not bad. Better than none.
whenever you're trying to cut specific shapes and specific things like this quarter sawn wood, you end up losing wood, and it's actually a waste of some of the lumber. But I mean, if you watch my channel, you know I've got lots and lots of red oak, so I'm not worried about losing a little bit of it. But I am worried about getting the nice boards I want.
Here's a little on the low side. I'll probably end up getting one, probably only get one out of that one. I got four spindles here. Four, so that's eight.
this will be two more to 10 now. I don't have a whole lot of 2-inch boards left here.
Now this cut that was on this is a little wavy, you can see it there. But if you look along this side, I mean that board is really straight. It having been quarter sawn, that's the reason for that, that it held itself so straight. Now sometimes quarter sawn doesn't work well, it depends if there's knots in it. But if you don't have any knots in it, you can end up getting some nice boards. Here to get the cut I need. Like I said, are for the spiral staircase. So what I do is cut them to 2x2 and then I'll plane them down to inch and a quarter, or inch and a half in both directions. I end up getting a really nice looking board deck. To get one out of there. what? That tool that I invented works pretty good. I mean, these are definitely, you know, cut the way we want them cut. It's just that they're hard to work with because you got angles everywhere. Cutting 2x2s is if the board's not straight, and sometimes they're not, like straight up and down on a 90 to the bunk rail, you end up with what's called a rhombus. Instead of a square, you end up with something that's kind of like not 90 degree angles, but four sides. The trouble with that thing is when you put it through the planer, it stays like that. It doesn't square up, because you're working with flat sides. So sometimes I have to throw a couple spindles away that don't work out. This one here might be okay. It has a little bit of a goofy angle on it there, but if you get one flat side, then you can plane the other side flat. Or on a 90 is what I'm talking about. trouble with that is it's not exactly a flat cut because it was leaning a little bit. Get the top here flat.
Thank you.
I've got some good wood there now. Okay, that gives me 18. More 2x2s. So the rest of this stuff then laying here is actually junk. So I have some junk laying there as well. I'm going to take that and throw it on here and get rid of the junk over at the firewood guy's place. And I'll take the 2x2s and put them over by the garage so I can cut them into spindle lengths and then plane them. Hey. So anyway, now you see that the LT15 can do some resawing, which I've done, I think the two videos back I was resawing. And that's what this is all about. I mean, I cut these into quarter sawn boards. I plan to use them for the handrail. That was 2 years ago. And I know that there's people out there who cannot plan that far ahead. It messes them all up and everything. But when you're, doing everything to make something happen, you have to follow through with all the steps. So knowing how many I need and cutting this 2 years ago and letting it dry was the important part. So now all I got to do is make the spindles, and then we can put this thing together after I stain them or polyurethane them. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Have a good one.